Hello friends, this is Ayush and in this video we'll be discussing the quant section of CAT 2017 evening slot paper. In this video we'll be having questions from time and work, time speed distance and permutation combinations. There will be 7 questions in this video. So let's start with the same. Question number 9. In a 10 kilometer race, ABC each running at uniform speed get gold, silver and bronze medals respectively. So there was a race of 10 kilometers. And three participants, A, B, C, were there, where A stood first, B second, and C third. A beats B by 1 kilometer, means when A completed the race of 10 kilometers, B was 1 kilometer away from the finish line. So in that case, B must have been at 9 kilometers. Also, B beat C by 1 kilometers, matlab when B completed the race of 10 kilometers, C was 1 kilometer away from the finish line, means C completed 9 kilometers. Since the ratio of their distances traveled will remain the same, so let it be x. 9 upon 10 for B should be equals to x upon 9. On cross multiplying, we'll have x equals to 81 upon 10, which is 8.1 kilometers. So when A completed 10 kilometers, C completed 8.1 kilometers. So A beats C by 10 minus 8.1. which is 1.9 kilometers. They've asked us the value in meters. So in that case, multiplying it by 1000, we'll have 1900 meters. So the correct answer for question number 9 is 1900 meters. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 10 is on the screen. Arun drove from hospital home to hostel at 60 miles per hour. Okay, fine. So Arun was moving from home to hostel at a speed of 60 miles per hour. Right, the distance is not given to us, so let us assume the distance to be D. While returning home, he drove half the way along the same route at a speed of 25 miles per hour. Okay, so half the way, matlab D by 2 distance, he traveled at a speed of 25 miles per hour. And then he took a bypass which increased his driving distance by 5 miles but allowed him to drive at 50 miles per hour along the bypass road. If the return journey took 30 minutes more than the onward journey, find the total distance traveled. Okay, fine. So when he was moving from home to hostel, he traveled a distance of D miles at 60 miles per hour. So time taken, it's D upon 60. In the return journey, he traveled D by 2 miles at 25 km speed. And D by 2 plus 5 miles at 50 km speed. And the time taken in second case was half an hour more than the time taken in first case. So on solving this, we'll have 1 by 2 equal to D by 50 plus D by 2 plus 5 upon 50 minus D by 60. I'll take the LCM. So with 300, we'll have 6D plus 3D plus 30 minus 5D. So this is 1 and this is 150. On cross multiplying, we'll have 150 equals to 4D plus 30. D equals to 30. Right. What they've asked us is the total distance traveled by him. So while going from home to hostel, he traveled a distance of 30 kilometers. While returning, he traveled that 30 kilometers plus 5 kilometers extra, 5 miles extra. So all of 65 miles was traveled by Arun during the entire journey. So the correct answer for question number 10 is option C, 65 miles. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 11 is on the screen. A tank has an inlet and outlet pipe. The outlet pipe is closed and the inlet pipe fills the empty tank in 8 hours. So if the inlet pipe alone is working, will take 8 hours to fill the tank. So 1 hour work will be 1 by 8. Similarly, if the outlet pipe is working alone, the time taken is not given to us, so let it be x. But when they are working together, it will take 10 hours to fill the tank. Right? So working together, the equation will be 1 by 8 is the time work done by the inlet pipe minus, because the outlet pipe is doing a negative work, 1 by x equals to the whole tank was filled in 10 hours. So in 1 hour, it will be 1 by 10. So on solving, I'll have 1 by x equals to 1 by 8 minus 1 by 10. which is equals to 1 by 40. Means outlet pipe will take 40 hours to empty the tank completely. But the question is, if only outlet pipe is open, in how many hours will the full tank becomes half full? Means we do not need to empty the full tank, we just need to empty the half tank, and for half tank the time will be half, that is 20 hours will be the correct answer. So for question number 11, the correct answer will be 20 hours, option A. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 12 is on the screen. A motorbike leaves point A at 1 p.m. Okay, so let me just draw the figure. This is the whole distance to be traveled. Let it be point A. Yahan se motorcycle is leaving at 1 p.m. Towards point B at a uniform speed, a car leaves. Yahan se a car will be leaving at 2 p.m. and move towards A at a uniform speed, which is double that of motorbike. So for motorbike, let the speed be X. For car, it will be 2X. They meet at 3:40 p.m. at a point which is 168 kilometers away from A. So let the point of meeting be this. This is 168 kilometers away from A, and let us label them as M. So they are meeting at a point M. What is the distance between A and B? Right. So when they are meeting at 3:40 p.m., duration of journey for motorcycle ki baat karte hain, time will be equals to 2 hours 40 minutes, that is 2 hours and 2 by 3 hours, which is 8 by 3 hours. And distance traveled is 168 kilometers. So we can calculate the speed. Speed will be equals to 168 upon 8 by 3. On cancellation with 21, we'll have speed is 63 kilometer per hour. So for motorcycle, the speed is 63 kilometer per hour. Car ki baat karte hain. Car ke liye speed will be twice, that will be 126 km per hour, and time. Since the car started 1 hour late, so would have traveled only 2 by 3 hours, that is 5 by 3 hours. So distance traveled by car will be equals to 126 into 5 by 3. This is 1, this is 42, 42 into 5 is 210 kilometers. Right. So this distance is 210 kilometers. What they've asked is the total distance between AB, so that will be AB equals to 168 plus 210 equals to 378 kilometers. So the total distance between A and B is 378 kilometers. Option B is the correct answer for question number 12. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 13 is on the screen. Amal can complete a job in 10 days. Okay, so if Amal can do a job in 10 days, one day work by Amal will be 1 by 10. Similarly, Bimal can complete the job in 8 days. So for Bimal, one day work will be 1 by 8. Right. And Kamal, Amal, Bimal and Kamal together can complete the job in 4 days. For Kamal, the time alone is not given to you. Let it be X, so it will be 1 by X. Forming the equation, we'll have 1 by 10 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by X equal to, they are completing the whole job in 4 days. That's 1 by 4 is the one day work. Right. So on solving, we'll have 1 by x equals to 1 by 4 minus 1 by 8 minus 1 by 10, which is equals to 1 by 40. So Kamal can complete the whole task alone in 40 days. Right. If they were being paid a remuneration of rupees 1000, so the remuneration is to be divided in the ratio of their one day work. Their one day work is 1 by 10, 1 by 8 and 1 by 40. So on taking the LCM to be 40, I'll have 4:5:1. Means the remuneration is to be divided into 4:5:1 ka ratio, where they have asked the Kamal, share of Kamal. So for share of Kamal, it will be 1 by 10 of the total remuneration of 1000 rupees, which turns out to be 100. So the correct answer for question number 13 is 100 rupees. Option A is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 14 is from permutation and combination. In how many ways 8 identical pens can be distributed among Amal, Bimal and Kamal? Okay, so we have to distribute 8 pens among Amal, Bimal and Kamal. Tino ko mila ke we have to distribute a total of 8 pens so that Amal gets at least 1 pen. Amal should get greater than equals to 1. Bimal should get greater than equals to 2. Kamal should get greater than equals to 3. So before applying the concept of distribution, we need to give them the minimum number of pens required. So after giving them, we'll be left with A dash, B dash, and K dash equals to 2, because we have already distributed 6 out of the 8 pens which we need to distribute. So for the remaining 2 pens left with us, we can apply the concept of distribution, where number of base is given by n plus r minus 1 cr minus 1. So n is the number of objects which is to be distributed, which is 2 over here. R is the number of people among which it is to be distributed, which is 3 here. So it will be n plus r minus 1 c r minus 1, which is equals to 4c2 is 6. So the total number of ways of distributing the objects among A, B, and K, that is Amal, Bimal, and Kamal, will be 6. So the correct answer for question number 14 is 6. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 15 is on the screen. How many 4-digit numbers which are divisible by 6 can be formed using the digits 0, 2, 3, 4, 6? Right. So divisibility of 6 is basically that the number should be divisible by 2 and 3 both. So for 2, the number should be even, that is the unit digit should be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. And for 3, the divisibility rules is that the sum of the digits should be divisible by 3. So I'm taking the first possible combination, which is 0, 2, 3 and 4. When I'm adding the digits, I'll get the sum as 9, which is divisible by 3. So all the numbers formed by the digits 0, 2, 3, 4 will be divisible by 3. And to make the number even, we have to keep either 0 or 2 or 4 at the unit place. Right. So let me make 3 different cases for them. If I'm putting 0 at the unit place, I'll be left with 3 options for the leftmost place, where I can put 2, 3 or 4. For the second place, it will be 2, and third, it will be 1, since repetition of digit is not allowed. So on multiplying, I'll get a total of 6 different numbers. If I'm putting 2 at the unit place, we'll have either 3 or 4, that is only 2 options are left for the leftmost place, because we cannot put 0 on the leftmost place. For the second position, again, we'll be left with 2 different numbers, and for third, it will be 1. So a total of 4 different numbers can be formed. If we are putting 4 at the units place, again, the cases will be 2, 2 and 1. That is a total of 4 different cases can be formed. Right? This is for the combination of 0, 2, 3 and 4. Let's take the second combination as 0, 2, 4 and 6. So here, there will be 4 different cases. When I'm putting 0 at the unit place, when I'm putting 2 at the unit place, 4 at the unit place and 6 at the unit place. For 0, there will be 3 options at the leftmost position, then 2 and 1, which is a total of 6 numbers. For 2, it will be 2, 2 and 1 as discussed earlier. So it will be 4. For 4, again, it will be 2, 2 and 1. That's 4. And for 6, again, it will be 2, 2 and 1. That's 4. Right. Considering the third combination, which is 2, 3, 4 and 6. Again, if we'll add the digits, we'll have the sum as 15, means all the numbers formed by the digits 2, 3, 4 and 6 will always be divisible by 3. So for such cases, we can have either 2, 4 or 6 at the init place. So there will be 3 options available. Right? If we are using either of the digits at the init place, we'll be left with 3 options for the leftmost place, then 2 and then 1, since repetition it's not allowed. So it's a total of 18, right? So adding all the cases, what we'll have is, this is 6 plus 4 plus 4, 14 cases are there. This is 6, 4, 4 and 4, that's a total of 18 cases are there. And again, it hits 18. So 14 plus 18 plus 18 adds up to 50. So there will be total 50 different numbers are possible under the conditions as mentioned in the question. So the correct answer for question number 15 is 50. So with this, we are done with all the questions from time and work, time speed distance and permutation combination. I hope the questions would be clear to you. In case if you have any kind of queries, you can post the query on our Facebook page. Thank you for watching the video.